If there's one thing that I've learned during this whole isolation period, it's that I love being alone. What's up, everybody? It's Tuesday, May 19th, and today I'm coming to you from my house. And I bring that up because I love this place. My house is not perfect. My house has a lot of room for development and needs a lot of things fixed. There are problems that I find every single day, but I love it. It's been an amazing experience to wake up every day and stay home, go outside, do work, work in and out of the house, and just work on taking care of my nest. And I gotta tell you, as somebody who's lived much of the gypsy life, as I know you have, Jonah, and many of the people in my life who are either convention people or in the film industry or entertainment in general, it's hard to have like a home. And so I thought this was a really amazing time for me personally, and hopefully for others, to be able to make something really positive out of a lot of negative, in that, you know, we have this time to really connect with our home and our sense of self. Now, if you ask my parents or anybody I've ever been close to, I've always been an independent person, but I have to tell you that the one thing that I say constantly throughout the year when I'm super busy is that I just feel stretched, I just feel thin, I just feel like I don't have any more to give. And that, that's always been true, but I feel like that's really been made even clearer by all this time home. I've really been able to feel like I've had time to sit and to think. There's been days where I just don't even open my mouth at all, where I just, it's dead silent, you know, except maybe to, you know, say hi to my cat. But I just feel like I have definitely learned during all this time that I really, really need to continue to cultivate a way in my life to be able to have this kind of quiet time, this grounding home time. As much as I love the film industry, as much as I love art, what I really, really need is stability in my sense of self and home. And this time has really made that even more clear in more ways that I can kind of utilize. More time at home doing projects is gonna make me happy. More quiet time without phone calls and emails and having to go to meetings, that's gonna help me, you know, with making sure that I'm not stretched too thin. And really, I think the biggest thing for me is that I love people. Like, community is one of my biggest things. And I feel like I need to be better at balancing my desire to go out and commune with people and also commune with myself. So that's been my biggest takeaway. I hope you guys have had some sort of positive takeaway from this whole experience. You know, I don't want to downplay how hard this has been. I mean, Jonah, you and I know how hard it's been, not just personally, but even as an art business in the film industry. It's been killer. And, you know, the future is unclear, but the reality is that as people, we are taking this time to, you know, really entrench ourselves in positivity and in creative solution problem solving. And I know that no matter what happens, you and I will figure out a way to just pick back up and keep on going. So I'm very, very thankful for the partnership that we have because of that, because there are a lot of people out there who don't have that kind of positive certainty that no matter what horrible things happen, they'll be okay. And so I think that's where, you know, for us, I think it's super important as creatives and people who know what it is to struggle with things like depression and exhaustion and all of those hard emotions that kind of take you when you're in a field that doesn't have a lot of stability. It's so important for us to support others. And, you know, for me, I think that's a big reason why I wanted to do something like a vlog, which is that it's like, I don't want to hear myself speak. You know, it's like, I want to connect with you. But I also feel like sometimes when we connect, the things that we kind of just come up with and talk with, they're things we all go through. They're things that everyone, they're not unique to us. And I just wanted to feel like, you know, instead of it just being two people talking in a room, you know, maybe we can just open up the conversation. And I know right now it's pretty much just me and you talking, but I absolutely can't wait for people to start commenting and getting engaged, because that's definitely going to influence how these videos go in the future, because we want that feedback and we want that engagement. And I'm excited for when that finally happens. Now, it may take a year, it may take 2 years, and that's okay. I just feel like, I really, you know, not just wanting to entrench myself in a sense of stability, you know, at home and personally, but I think that, you know, outside of just the drive of going, you know, at 80 miles an hour in the film industry and always trying to figure out what job's going to be next, But I just feel like it would be amazing to be able to have things we rely on, like connecting every day like this, or being able to put out information and share stuff, because that's what matters to me and you. You and I have always talked about this, and I even got this quote from my dad, but that's that the problem with the self-made man is that he tends to worship his own creator, and I truly believe that, and I really feel like it's important to remember that, you know, me, you, and everyone around us is not, you know, they're really not responsible fully and completely for who they are. We're all products of the support and love, or even the hardship and consequences of negative experiences that affect how we operate on a daily basis. And so for that, it's like I always just want to try to put out a little bit. You know, I feel like I've gotten so much as a person and as an artist that I always just want to put out more positivity, more resources, more help, more knowledge, more power into other people's hands. And Jonah, I guess I'll leave you with that then. My question for you for tomorrow is, what is it that makes you feel the most connected to someone else? I'd love to hear what you think. If nothing else, hopefully it'll help me figure out how to connect better with you as business partners and maybe even connect better with our audience. And that is going to be it for me today. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining. I hope you're enjoying these updates. And if you have any comments, suggestions, or questions, drop them in the comment section here. Or if you're seeing this on Facebook, Instagram, there too. Check our description. I'm going to have links to Jonah and I's personal Instagrams, as well as the Blue Whale Studio Instagram. And I look forward to seeing what you have for me tomorrow. I'll see you later. Stay creative.